We would like to welcome everyone to join us here at Friendship Lutheran Church of Joy in Champaign, Illinois, as we continue in this season of Lent. Let us pray. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we remain in darkness without your light, and we walk in blindness if you do not lead. Even in our times of comfort with darkness and the times where we give in to our willful blindness, you shine your light of truth and call us your children, that we may see and live in your grace. We pray that you would help us to acknowledge your goodness, give thanks for all of your blessings, and have eyes of faith that look to you always, so that we may serve you and others in willing obedience. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Holy Gospel, according to St. John, the 9th chapter, beginning at the first verse. As he passed by, he saw a man blind from birth. And his disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" Jesus answered, "It was not that this man sinned or his parents, but that the works of God might be displayed in him. We must work the works of him who sent me while it is day. Night is coming when no one can work. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world." Having said these things, he spit on the ground and made mud with the saliva. Then he anointed the man's eyes with the mud and said to him, "Go wash in the pool of Siloam," which means sent. So he went and washed and came back seeing. The neighbors and those who had seen him before as a beggar were saying, "Is this not the man who used to sit and beg?" Some said, "It is he." Others said, "No, but he is like him." He kept saying, "I am the man." So they said to him, "Then how were your eyes opened?" He answered, "The man called Jesus made mud and anointed my eyes and said to me, 'Go to Siloam and wash.' So I went and washed and received my sight." They said to him, "Where is he?" He said, "I do not know." They brought to the Pharisees the man who had formerly been blind. Now it was the Sabbath day when Jesus made the mud and opened his eyes. So the Pharisees again asked him how he received his sight. And he said to them, "He put mud on my eyes and I washed and I see." Some of the Pharisees said, "This man is not from God, for he does not keep the Sabbath." But others said, "How can a man who is a sinner do such signs?" And there was a division among them. So they said again to the blind man, "How do you say about him, since he has opened your eyes?" He said, "He is a prophet." The Jews did not believe that he had been blind and had received his sight until they called the parents of the man who had received his sight. And they asked him, "Is this your son who you say was born blind? How then does he now see?" His parents answered, "We know that this is our son and that he was born blind, but how he now sees we do not know, nor do we know who opened his eyes. Ask him, he is of age, he will speak for himself." His parents said these things because they feared the Jews, for the Jews had already agreed that if anyone should confess Jesus to be the Christ, he was to be put out of the synagogue. Therefore his parents said, "He is of age, ask him." So for the second time they called the man who had been blind and said to him, "Give glory to God. We know that this man is a sinner." He answered, "Whether he is a sinner, I do not know. One thing I do know, that though I was blind, now I see." They said to him, "What did he do to you? How did he open your eyes?" He answered them, "I have told you already, and you will not listen. Why do you want to hear it again? Do you also want to become his disciples?" And they reviled him, saying, "You are his disciple, but we are disciples of Moses. We know that God has spoken to Moses, but as for this man, we do not know where he comes from." The man answered, "Why, this is an amazing thing. You do not know where he comes from, and yet he opened my eyes. We know that God does not listen to sinners, but if anyone is a worshiper of God and does his will, God listens to him. Never since the world began has it been heard that anyone opened the eyes of a man born blind. If this man were not from God, he could do nothing." They answered him, "You were born in utter sin, and would you teach us?" and they cast him out. Jesus heard that they had cast him out, and having found him, Jesus said, "Do you believe in the Son of Man?" The man answered, "And who is he, sir, that I may believe in him?" Jesus said to him, "You have seen him, and it is he who is speaking to you." He said, "Lord, I believe." And he worshiped him. Jesus said, "For judgment I came into this world, that those who do not see may see, and those who see may become blind." Some of the Pharisees near him heard these things and said to him, "Are we also blind?" And Jesus said to them, "If you were blind, you would have no guilt. But now that you say we see, your guilt remains." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Grace, peace, and mercy be unto you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. As we continue our Lenten journey, we are looking at how folks who actually got to see Jesus in the flesh, what they saw when they saw Jesus of Nazareth. And in this looking at how each one of them saw him, we contemplate how we have had similar views and how our views may be a little bit different. In this particular section of John's Gospel, chapter 9, in the history of all theological scholarship, John chapter 9 has taken on a life of its own, which in effect has detached the content from both its context and the significance of the gospel message that is found within it. Many are content to let the meaning of the miracle reside within just the miracle itself. But we all know that each moment of our life is a moment to itself. And every event that happens in our lives is a moment to itself. And our lives are made up of all of these moments, and some of these moments have more significant meaning to us than others. We have life before the event, and then we have life after the event. And the event only has its meaning in the changes that it makes to our life. As I said, we have life before the event and life after the event. For the blind man, how did he see Jesus? Well, at first he didn't even see Jesus. But then Jesus spit on the ground, made some mud, and placed it on his eyes. Now, a lot of folks are going to try to attach significant meaning to how Jesus did this, but that's not really the point. You see, Jesus could do anything. The mud that he created with his spit, the dirt that was on the ground, he created it. So therefore, he could do anything he wanted with it. Sometimes we get lost with trying to find the meaning in the event itself instead of viewing the more significance that we find with what happens after the event. So before the event, the blind man spent every moment of his life in darkness. But life after the event is a whole different story. You see, that moment, that event, had such significance in this man's life. Not only was he given the gift of sight, but he also came to see Jesus as the light of the world. Now, last week, you may remember that in John chapter 4, we saw the woman at the well. who came to see Jesus as living water. And this week we see Jesus being the light of the world. And in between we have Jesus in John chapter 6 being the life, the bread of life. Now for this man, everyone saw the changes that occurred in this man. They saw the change that occurred after this event, this one moment in time, this encounter with Jesus. And others wanted to know what has happened. What was this glorious thing that happened to him? And you gotta love his response. I don't know how, but I do know who. You see, once I was blind, but now I see. And the Pharisees, how were they looking at Jesus at this moment? How were they looking at this event? What was their life before this event? And what did this event, or how should I say, did this event affect them in the future? You see, they claim to be disciples of Moses. They are still living in the darkness of the law. And the parents, how did they see him? I'm sure that they were ecstatic, they were happy that now their son could see. But out of fear, they told the Pharisees, ask him yourself. We don't want to make any claims that may get us tossed out of the synagogue. Well, how about you? Have your eyes been opened by the light of the world? Have you had that moment, that event, where everything before changes and everything after becomes something new? You see, everything changes when you come to know Jesus. Not just as the man, not just as a prophet, not just as a good teacher, not just as a rabbi, but when you come to recognize, when you see Jesus as who he is, for who he is, when you see Jesus and you see God, everything must change. You see, we have those moments before this encounter and we have the rest of our life after. Are you still in the darkness or are you still in the light? You see, the beauty is that this does change everything. You see, everything changes in a moment where the before gives way to the after. And that after is what brings us everlasting life. Amen.
'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rains unending.
Let us pray for the whole church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. We pray, gracious Lord, that you would shine your light of mercy and grace into hearts darkened by sin and open eyes that have been blinded to your will, so that we may grasp the fullness of your love, forgiveness, life, and peace. Lord, in your mercy, we pray that you would hear our prayer. Healing, Lord, shine your light of peace and healing to all who seek relief, for the sick and the dying, for those who are troubled physically, spiritually, emotionally, and mentally, and for those who grieve, that your comfort would be known. Lord, we pray these things in your mercy, that you would hear our prayer. Lord of all nations, we pray that you would shine your light to all places in this world, and may your light guide and direct our leaders so that peace and justice would faithfully be served. We pray that you would give courage and diligence to all who work to defend our liberties, and give voice to those who speak for those who cannot speak for themselves. Lord, in your mercy, we pray that you would hear our prayer. Lord of the church, we pray that you would shine your light upon all you have enabled to speak and proclaim your word. We pray that you would be with our congregation, and we pray that you would remain, that we would remain united in truth, love, faith, and service to your kingdom. We pray that you would give courage to all of us, that we would live as your witnesses, that many who remain in darkness would then come to rejoice in the light of your truth. We pray for Tyler and for the congregation to which you will have him serve. Lord, we come to you in your mercy, praying that you would hear our prayer. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We pray that you would remember us in your kingdom, as you have taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. Amen.
The Lord has promised good to me. His word, my hope, secures. He will my share and portion be as long as life endures. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, his mercy rains, unending love, amazing grace. Will be forever.